Hello everybody, welcome to the JavaScript course. In this video, I'm going to discuss weak sets in JavaScript. What is a weak set? Let us investigate the situation. Suppose we have an object in a weak set. But if the object is deleted outside the weak set can lose that object automatically. In this way, we can save more memory than an ordinary set does. And one thing to remind you is that a weak set cannot do iteration, and I'm going to demonstrate all these main points to you with examples. Now, let us see the HTML file first. The HTML file is quite simple. I have a title and a heading, and the HTML file is linked to a JavaScript file. The file name is called myscript.js, which is put in the JS folder. And now I'm going to show you the JavaScript file. In order for me to use the strict mode, I want to say use strict on the first line of the JavaScript file. And now I'm going to demonstrate the meaning of weak sets in JavaScript. Let me discuss the situation in an ordinary set. Suppose an object becomes an entry of a set. If the object is deleted from the memory, the object will still appear in the set. It means that the memory is still occupied. So let us see an example like this one. Suppose I have three objects, dog, cat, and rabbit, and I want to put all these three objects into a set called animals. So how can I do it? I just use the add method. Okay, so now the set of animals has three objects. And how can I demonstrate the problem with the ordinary set? I just want to delete one object. I want to delete an object called dog. So it seems like I have only two objects remaining, and we have to notice that the deletion is done outside the setup. Okay. And I can see whether the dog is already gone. So let me see the result. Save. Reload. Yes, you can see that the dog is gone. So in principle, I have only two objects remaining. So you might expect that the set also has only two objects remaining, because the dog here should be gone when I do the deletion outside the set declaration. But it is not the case. So let me show you the number of elements in the animal set. So let's see the number of elements in my set now. Save. Reload. Yes, you can see number 3 coming out. So it seems like the deletion of the dog object outside the set declaration doesn't help me to delete the dog element in my set immediately. So that is a weakness of an ordinary set. It means that the set still has 3 objects, one of which should already be gone. So I can also show the content of my set in more detail by using a for loop. So I can use the for loop to loop over all the objects contained in my set. Save. Reload. Yes, the first element is a dog. And the content is shown here. The second one is a cat, and the content is shown here. The third element is a rabbit, and the content is shown here. So we can see that the animals set still has 3 elements, which should not be the case when I already delete one element out of the set declaration. So if an object is already deleted, it is still also deleted in a weak set. So this is the advantage of using a weak set. So let us see an example. Now suppose I have 3 objects, all of which are books. And I want to create a weak set by using these 3 objects. So the idea to set up a weak set is like this. I put all the three objects into an array, and then I put that array into the parameter of a weak set. So I also use the new keyword. In this case, the books is representing a weak set, and the weak set called books has three objects. If you don't like to use one assignment statement to set up a weak set, I can still use separate addition shown here. So these lines are equivalent to a single statement shown above, like this one. Okay, I set up an empty weak set and then I add three objects into my weak set by using the add function. Okay, so we can use both approaches to assign a weak set. Okay, the merit of using a weak set is that when an object is deleted outside this weak set declaration, the corresponding element in the weak set is also gone. So let us see the example like this one. Suppose I want to delete the science book. So after the assignment, I have only two objects remaining. And I can demonstrate the idea to you now. How about the science book? The science book is already deleted outside my reset declaration. So it is sensible that the weak set called books doesn't contain the science book. Save. Reload. Yes, you see, when I use the has method, I can see false as the answer. That means the science book is gone in my weak set as well. So in principle, I have only two books remaining. So let me save the file and reload the page. Yes, you can see that the weak set still has the history book, and the weak set has also the art book. Okay, so these are the only two objects remaining in my weak set called books. So in this case, the memory corresponding to the science book is also removed from the weak set memory. In this case, the memory in the weak set can be saved. And one thing to notice is that a weak set disallows iteration. So when I use a for loop like this one, it is impossible for me to get the content of my weak set. Save. Reload. Yes, you can see that when I click on the refresh button, I'm unable to show the alert windows. The reason is that a weak set disallows iteration. So this video has already discussed a lot of things about a weak set. We have noticed the shortcoming of using an ordinary set. The shortcoming is that the memory in the ordinary set will still be remained even though that object in a set is already gone outside the set declaration. But when I use a weak set and delete an object out of this weak set declaration, the weak set content doesn't store that deleted object. So this is the way to save memory in my weak set. And of course, I have to say again that a weak set doesn't allow iteration. So it is not possible for me to do the alert window shown in this for loop. This is the end of the video. If you have any questions about my video, please leave your questions on the comment section below the video. If you like this video, please give me a like and please subscribe to my channel. Thank you for watching.